before the Mass. Prepare yourselves well for it. Do not watch it with a cup of coffee in hand. Read the Mass readings to prepare yourselves. Think what you are to thank the Lord for and what to offer to Him this Mass. Remember, you are praying this Eucharist with many other fellow Catholics. During the Mass, stay in reverent gesture throughout the Mass. Pray with the whole family. Join in prayers, response, and singing. At the time of communion, make a spiritual communion. After the Mass, take some moments of silence to read again the scriptural readings and reflect.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. We have some announcements. A candle altar along the bridge going to Greenbelt 4 is available for you to light a candle for your particular intentions. We will now have additional 5:30 p.m. Mass every Wednesday and Friday. Starting November 22, we will follow this new Sunday schedule of Masses, 12 noon, 2 p.m., 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. The chapel is now accepting donations for victims of the recent typhoon. You may go to the chapel office or you may use other payment channels posted in our chapel Facebook page. Let us all kneel and pray the act of consecration of the human race to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Altogether, most sweet Jesus, Redeemer of the human race, look down upon us, humbly prostrate before your altar. We are yours, and yours we wish to be. But to be more surely united to you, behold, each one of us freely consecrates ourselves today to your most sacred heart. Many indeed have never known you. Many too, despising your precepts, have rejected you. Have mercy on them all, most merciful Jesus, and draw them to your sacred heart. Be King, O Lord, not only of the faithful children who have never forsaken you, but also of the prodigal children who have abandoned you. Grant that they may quickly return to their father's house, lest they die of wretchedness and hunger. Be king of those who are deceived by the erroneous opinions of whom discord keeps aloof, and call them back to the harbor of truth and unity of faith, so that soon there may be but one flock and one shepherd. Grant, O Lord, to your church assurance of freedom and immunity from harm. Give peace and order to all nations, and make the earth resound from pole to pole with one cry. Praise to the divine heart that wrought our salvation. To it be glory and honor forever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Welcome to the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. Today is November 22, 2020, and we celebrate the Solemnity of Christ the King. Our presider for this Holy Sacrifice of the Mass is our chaplain, Reverend Father June Ciscon. Please stand and let us sing the entrance hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of Jesus, our Lord, the King of the universe, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, dear sisters and brothers, as we celebrate this Mass on the last Sunday of the liturgical year, the calendar of the Church. And on this last Sunday of the liturgical year, we celebrate the solemnity of Jesus Christ, King of the universe, King of history. And we are here, despite the pandemic, despite the many challenges in life, because we want to profess our faith in Jesus, our King. Because we know that if Jesus reigns over us, His peace, His justice, His triumph will also be ours. And so, let us open our hearts. Let us allow the Lord to reign over us. Let us also, with humility, beg the Lord's pardon for the times we have allowed sin to reign over us, for the times we have allowed sin to destroy our relationships, to destroy our lives. Let us beg the Lord's mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May our loving God have mercy on us, grant us healing and peace, teach us to forgive one another, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majesty's service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Let us now listen to the word of the Lord.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will look after and tend my sheep, as a shepherd tends his flock when he finds himself among his scattered sheep, so will I tend my sheep. I will rescue them from every place where they were scattered when it was cloudy and dark. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will give them rest, says the Lord God. The lost I will seek out. The strayed I will bring back. The injured I will bind up. The sick I will heal. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy, shepherding them rightly. As for you, my sheep, says the Lord God, I will judge between one sheep and another, between rams and goats. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. When everything is subjected to him, Then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who subjected everything to him, so that God may be all in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us now honor the Holy Gospel. Together, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the kingdom of our father David that is to come.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me, naked and you clothed me, ill and you cared for me, in prison and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' And the king will say to them and reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on the left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. A stranger and you gave me no welcome. Naked and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or ill or in prison and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And this will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life." Sisters and brothers, the good news of our salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon, dear sisters and brothers, and once again, welcome to the celebration of the Holy Mass, and thank you for coming over. I know it's difficult for some of you, especially those who are standing outside. I'm sure the Lord is very much pleased that despite the restrictions, despite the difficulties and inconvenience and the risks, we continue to gather in His name, especially today as we celebrate the solemnity of Christ the King. And every time we gather for Mass, we praise and thank God. We also welcome those who are joining us online, especially those who are homebound, those who are sick, those who are taking care of the sick, those who cannot yet go out. We are one body of Christ as we celebrate this Mass. And as I said, our main disposition during these pandemic times as we praise, as we celebrate the Mass, is gratitude. Salamat sa Diyos at nandito tayo. Salamat sa Diyos at nagkakatipon pa rin tayo. Our presence here is a blessing. We couldn't ask for more. The Lord has been so kind and gracious to bring us here. And we pray in safety. Let me have as our reflection today a recapitulation of what we have been being prepared for. And that's why I want to bring to mind the two previous Gospels of the Sundays before this solemnity. If you will notice, the readings have been preparing us for this solemnity. That's why you will notice the themes of the readings for the past three Sundays are about judgment and facing the King, the Judge, and the Master. Just two simple points. Whenever we talk about judgment, sometimes our imagery is it will be a test between those who do good versus those who do evil. And that is true. That is one test during Judgment Day. Those who are doing good and those who are doing evil. However, we are also reminded that will not just be the basis of the final judgment. It will also be between those who are doing good and doing nothing. Obvious na po yun eh. Those who are doing good versus those who are doing evil. But one thing that we need to remember, which is a more serious challenge, the test will also be between those who are doing good and doing nothing. Let's go back to those two parables, two previous Sundays. Remember the parable of the five foolish virgins? Why were they excluded from the feast? Did they do something wrong? Not really. But rather, they were excluded because they did nothing. They did not prepare well. They did not get that extra oil. Remember that parable? They were not really disobedient. They were not really wicked. But their main fault was they did nothing. Last Sunday, the parable of the talents. The third servant was punished. Why? Sinayang ba niya yung bigay sa kanya? Nilustay ba niya? Winala ba niya? Hindi po, di ba? Anong ginawa lang niya? Ibinaon lang niya. Tinago lang niya. In other words, he did nothing. And that is why today in the gospel, when Jesus, the King, confronts those on the left and the right, he said, I was hungry, you gave me no food. I was thirsty, you gave me no drink. I was sick and you did not care for me. I was in prison, you did not visit me. I was naked, you did not clothe me. In other words, Jesus is saying, you did nothing. Sisters and brothers, indifference is another mask of evil. Akala kasi natin, pag sinabing evil, ito yung taong pumapatay, nagnanakaw, gumagawa ng masama. But today we are reminded, indifference is also a mask of evil. And the devil is very clever. He has used this well. Because many people do not think that when you are indifferent, you are not on the side of evil. But today, Jesus reminds us, when you are indifferent, you don't care, you don't mind others, you are doing nothing, then you are not also on my side. Nowadays, we are asking ourselves, what is the most dangerous place? Di ba, minsan pinag-uusapan yan, saan mga pinakadelikado? Kayang iba, wag tayong lalabas, delikado sa labas. Wag tayong pumunta sa simbahan, delikado sa simbahan. Tapos may tumawag, ay, birthday po, punta kayo. O sige, punta tayo doon, no? Ay, mas delikado ho yung birthday party, no? Mas delikado pumunta sa restaurant. I'm not saying that let us be reckless, but today we are also be reminded the most dangerous place is not actually out there or here. The most dangerous place is when you're so inside of yourself that you become so blind, so detached, so indifferent, especially to the sufferings of others. Yes, we are all suffering. Yes, we are all in need. But today is a good reminder, do not do nothing, even a little, to help others is a gesture towards the kingdom of God. It is not just between doing good versus doing evil. It is about doing good versus doing nothing. And I said, it is very dangerous because when you are indifferent, you are killing both the body and the soul. Maraming namamatay dahil maraming ayaw makialam. Maraming hindi maliligtas dahil marami rin ang ayaw makialam. Second point, yes, I say it is about doing good. But let me also warn and remind each and everyone, going to heaven is not about doing good. We are not doing good so that we can go to heaven. Please be clear about it. Heaven is not a reward for the do-gooders. Entering heaven is not simply about doing good. Not a few times I hear people, pwede naman ako hindi magsimba o maniwala sa Diyos. Papasok din naman ako sa langit kasi gumagawa naman ako ng mabuti eh. Wala naman akong inaargabyado. Wala naman akong ginagawang masama. Yun nga nagsisimba eh. Yun nga nagsasabing naniniwala sa Diyos. Sila nga yung mga corrupt. Sila nga yung masasama. But sisters and brothers, Christianity is not an ethical system or a moral code. Christianity is not about doing good. Christianity is about a person, Jesus Christ. And that is why our faith, our religion is about a relationship with Him. Going to heaven is not about doing good. Going to heaven is about recognizing Jesus, knowing Jesus, loving Jesus. That's why going back to the two parables, remember towards the end, when they were trying to enter the feast, anong sabi dun sa five foolish virgins? I do not know you. Remember last Sunday, what was the fault of the third servant? He did not know the master. That's why he made the wrong moves. He did not know the master. And now, in the parable today, what was the ending? They did not know it was Jesus. See, entering heaven is not simply about doing good. Entering heaven is about knowing Jesus, recognizing Jesus. That's why notice when Jesus was trying to confront those to be judged, he said, I was hungry. And you did not give me food. Notice this, Jesus didn't say, you gave the poor, you gave the hungry, you visited the prisoners. No, Jesus was referring to himself. You gave me, you helped me, you cared for me. In other words, doing good should lead us to recognize Jesus. Mga kapatid, ngayong panahon na to, salamat, maraming tumutulong, maraming gumagawa ng mabuti. But let us move further. It is not simply about doing good. You can do good to feel good. You can do good to be proud. Ipopost mo, oh, daig ko kayo, ako ang dami kong tinulungan. May patarpulin pa kung anong ginawa ko. You can do good and let others be indebted to you. Pwede tayong gumawa ng mabuti, pero sa bandang huli, hindi pala nakabuti sa atin. Napahamak pa tayo. And that is why in the end, yes, let us help those in Albay, in Catanduanes, in Cagayan, in Isabela, in Marikina. But for every Christian, our next step is, did I see Jesus in them? Did I see God in what was happening in my life? Because that is the fruition, the completion of every good deed that we do. We are not just simply doing good. We are, in the end, recognizing Jesus. Kaya yung mga papasok sa heaven, diba, sabi na, ay, ikaw pala yung tinulungan namin. Ikaw pala, Lord, yung dinalaw namin. Because in the end, they were led to the realization that they need to see Jesus. And so, sisters and brothers, as we continue with this Mass, let us pray for that grace. Yes, Lord, banish indifference in our hearts. If we are washing our hands, sanitizing ourselves, getting rid of all the bacteria and the virus, please don't forget to get rid of indifference, because that is a deadlier virus. As I said, indifference kills both the body and the soul. And secondly, Lord, as we do good, may we see you. May we recognize you. It is not about us. It is not even about heaven. Sabi po ng iba, if you're doing good just to enter heaven, that is still a selfish motivation. Because that will still be about us. But if we will be doing good because we want to see Jesus in others, then that is the time we will enter and share in the Master's joy. As we continue with this Mass, let us pray. Lord, be our King. Reign over us so that we can see you, so that we can do something good, so that we can love you more, so that we can be part of your kingdom. Reign over us, Jesus, our King. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us now present our petitions to our Lord and King, opening our hearts so that we may be inflamed by His love. Let our response be, Christ our King, hear our prayer.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For all believers, may they take seriously the Last Judgment and the implication of the Incarnation. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Father and all other spiritual leaders, may their example of humble service to the needy be readily followed by all people of goodwill. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For teachers, doctors, nurses, and social workers, may they render their service to the students, the sick, and the poor in a spirit of faith. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the oppressed, and the afflicted, may they experience the loving care of God through the charity and solidarity of their brethren. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For all those who have participated in the observance of the Year of Ecumenism, interreligious dialogue, and of the indigenous people, may they receive abundant rewards. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
For all of us, on the day of the Last Judgment, may we hear Christ's invitation to enter the kingdom of the Father. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
Christ our King, hear our prayer.
Lord God, grant us a new determination to make the most of the opportunities you give us for our own good and for the good of the Church and all mankind. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son Himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as eternal priest and king of all creation, so that by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption, and making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
For those who cannot kneel, please put your right hand on your chest as a sign of reverence.
Every time we celebrate the Mass, we see Jesus in the bread and wine that will be consecrated. Let us pray that we may also see Jesus in our lives, that we may see Jesus in our neighbor. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, Saint Michael, the Archangel, our protector, Saint Padre Pio, Saint John Paul II, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now call on our loving Father. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, and now you're saying it to all of us, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Lord, do not look on our sins. Forgive us, Lord, when we are indifferent to evil and suffering. Pardon us, Lord, when we do good not out of love for you. Lord, look on the faith, the charity of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us see Jesus in one another and exchange peace. For a safe and orderly distribution of Holy Communion, please follow the ushers. Those inside the chapel, everybody must stand and follow the flow. Even if you will not receive communion, please stand and follow the flow, because we are avoiding people from crossing each other or getting too close, because that is dangerous. So if you will not stand and move, your seatmate will find it difficult to get out for communion. So out of charity, please stand, follow the flow. If you will not receive communion, just cross your hand and I will bless you and you may return to your place. To those who are outside the chapel, lay ministers will be going out. They will be the ones to approach you so you don't have to crowd. Please maintain distancing, and the lay ministers will be the one to go to you. Just come closer. if you are within the vicinity, so that we will know that you want to receive communion. I will just say once, the body of Christ, and you will all already answer Amen. So you don't have to say anything. When we give you communion, it will be done in silence, which is much safer. But in that silent moment today, as we celebrate Christ the King, as you receive Jesus, pray, Lord, reign over me. Lord, may your kingdom come. Behold Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Judge, and our King. The Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us all kneel and pray the Oratio Imperata against COVID-19. Altogether, God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transition. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael, the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that glorifying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with Him eternally in His heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So thank you to our servants and staff who are helping us sustain our religious activities during this time of pandemic. And again, thank you for coming over and thank you for cooperating. I know sometimes our rules are inconvenient for you, but we're doing this to make sure that Greenbelt Chapel is a safe space. And our tagline here at Greenbelt Chapel is, we return not as customers. If out there, customers are demanding, are looking for so many things, we return here as disciples. As I said earlier, magpasalamat tayo sa Diyos at tayo'y nandito. At sapat na iyon na nandito tayo kahit mahirap, kahit nakakapagod, kahit nakatayo tayo, because our presence here is a blessing already. And we are here above all to recognize Jesus, because that is the way to follow Him. So thank you for cooperating and thank you for your support, for the help we have extended to the typhoon victims, and we continue to accept your donations. And please, this is the time. Yes, we have been spared and many people are saying we were blessed, but now is the time that we become a blessing to those who are suffering. And we want to make sure everything you give will be given to those who are in need right now. We are channeling everything through the Caritas Social Action Centers of the different dioceses who identify who really needs help the most. So thank you for being in solidarity. As reminded to us today, let us not do nothing. And I forgot to mention earlier, what's the difference between goat and sheep? Nakalimutan ko kanina sa homily po. Sabi po ng isang Bible scholar, sheep have wool. That's why in the evening, they could withstand the cold. But the goats have a thinner skin, no? Or hair. That's why yung mga kambing daw, dahil nilalamig, kailangan dalhin sa mas mainit na lugar. Ang ganda ng gospel, no? Dinala nga sila sa mainit na lugar. Umaapoy pa, no? Bakit? Dahil nilalamig sila. Isn't it that indifference is also about coldness? So let us pray that we may not be plagued by a deadlier virus, the coldness of indifference. And so now, as I give this blessing, let us remember people right now who need the help of Jesus, the divine healer, the good shepherd, the divine king. Especially those who cannot come for Mass, those who are very sick, those who are having difficulties right now, let us remember them. Let us show to the Lord we care for one another. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing, and remember now the people you want to share this blessing. May God bless you with every heavenly blessing, make you always holy and pure in His sight, pour out in abundance upon you the richness of His glory, and teach you with words of truth and love. May He instruct you in the gospel of salvation and endow you with fraternal charity and allow you entry into His kingdom, where He lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go, discover Jesus out there.
Thanks be to God.
Let us give Christ the King a clap offering.
Please be seated.